Hello viewers and learners, I extend a warm welcome to the present module on Course Management System and Tools Part 2. With today's greeting, I am Professor Naseeb Singh Gill from Department of Computer Science and Applications and Director, Digital Learning Initiatives and Monitoring Cell of Maharshi Dayanand University, Rohtak, Haryana. Learning Management System and Course Management System are becoming a vital part of classrooms in the 21st century. In the earlier module, we have discussed in detail and in depth about the course management system and learning management systems, as well as their relevance among the faculty and students in educational institutions. This module aims to bring clarity about the use of learning and course management systems, which are also known for short as LMS or CMS, and tools, as well as their important ingredients or elements. Though few learning management system tools which are very popular in education sector include primarily Moodle. Moodle is an acronym for Modular Object Oriented Dynamic Learning Environment. Another tool is Blackboard. Another important tool is Google Classroom. Another tool is Swam, as well as another important tool is Canvas. Ministry of Human Resources and Development, Government of India, has also launched its own learning management platform and system that is called SWAM. SWAM stands for Study Webs of Active Learning for Young Aspiring Minds. SWAM is an Indian electronic e-education platform which offer courses from the high school stage to postgraduate stage in an interactive electronic platform. The present module is aimed to get learners a practical orientation and exposure of few popular learning and course management systems. Before we move further, let's enumerate the learning outcomes of the present module. Learners will be able to understand, number one, background of course management system and learning management system. Number two, popular learning and course management systems and tools. Number three, how to use a learning management system or course management system by teachers and students. Number four, practical orientation of popular learning and course management systems and tools, and which would include our practical demonstration on Moodle. And under Moodle, we'll be able to understand what is the Moodle, what are its features and capabilities. Similarly, another learning management system, SWAM. As a part of this, we will also discuss overview of SWAM, its functionality and use and relevance. Similarly, we'll also discuss about three important tools that is called Google Classroom, which would include its discussion onto its overview and capabilities. So first of all, let's learn about course management system and its relevance in the present digital age. We have already discussed about course management system and LMS in detail in the earlier module, and by now we have already gained an understanding about their relevance in the present education and learning environment. It is pertinent to mention that course management systems are in general inclusive in almost all LMS, that is learning management system. There are many tools that have come up in the recent years for managing online learning in higher education. But learning management systems are still at the center of it all. Most educators and administrators rely and depend upon learning management systems for developing course contents, tracking student progress, measuring and reporting student performance. As already briefed, there are many learning management systems available as open source, commercial, on the cloud, and or through certified partners. Now let's step forward towards the important and very popular open source learning management system, that is Moodle, which stands for Modular Object Oriented Dynamic Learning Environment. Moodle is one of the world's popular open source learning platform. Moodle allows educators of any kind to create a private space online filled with tools that easily create courses and activities, all optimized for collaborative learning. Depending on your requirements and available resources, there are mainly three options to get Moodle as your online learning platform. First method is, as Moodle is open source, you can directly download Moodle from the website download.moodle.org. Second method is, get a Moodle cloud site. And the Moodle cloud site is moodlecloud.com, which is hosted by Moodle headquarters. That is the company and the people behind Moodle. Please note that there are different packages for Moodle Cloud, up to 500 learners and specific data storage. Third method is, work with one of certified Moodle partners, which you can access from the website moodle.com/partners, who provide various services from starting from configuration, hosting, upgrading, customization services for your Moodle platform. Here are few quick steps which you can follow to create a course in Moodle. Number one, ensure that you are a course creator within Moodle. Without these privileges, you may not have sufficient access to create courses. Number two, navigate to the category you would like your course to appear in and click on the Add a New Course button. Number three, name your course and give it a short name as well. Number four, set the start date and the period during which students can enroll in the course. Number five, there are other settings you can alter at this stage, including whether to hide specific sections from students, whether grade should be visible or hidden, and so many others. Number six, by default, courses are created with four empty blocks, which includes latest news, upcoming events, recent activity, and course administration. With this brief understanding of Moodle environment, now let's learn more in detail about Moodle. Now let us have
a practical orientation and exposure of our Moodle learning management system. As already outlined and shared with you, we have several ways of using Moodle LMS. And to get exactly a practical exposure, now you just please start performing the steps as I am performing on the system. You have to open up your browser and accordingly you have to move step by step. Just like I am opening up, is your visit the website moodle.org. After you enter, you will get this website. Or if you want to start afresh, you can again open up any browser, whether it may be your Internet Explorer, it could be Mozilla Firefox, it could be google.com. And what you have to do is, you have to open up this website. Here is the website available. And now on the screen, if you notice, we are having the home button. If you see the pointer, and if you move on to the next part, it is documentation. Let me make you aware of what is available in the Moodle learning management system. If you look over this second option, that is your documentation, and if you click it, you will be served this screen. So you are noticing what it shows. It shows Moodle Docs, and it also shows the Moodle Docs version 3.6. So what it is having, if you look at, this is the first, your main page that shows getting started. Under getting started, it shows you browse features, teacher quick guide, admin quick guide, installation quick guide. Similarly, more quick guides it also shows. If you move in the middle block, manage your course. So what you can do is, with this option, you can set up your courses, you can add students, you can track the progress of the students, you can upload files, and you can also do several more operations. If I'm pressing it, that is your more for teachers, it can also show you the different guidelines, that you're managing a Moodle course. So these are the several instructions and your guidelines which are available. Again, if you look in the just next option, you are having another on the rightmost block, it is your add activities. So looking at this, the first option is use assignments to assess, discuss in forums, test students with quiz, that is your peer assess with workshop, and there are several more activities you can also have a look at. That shows our several activities as a part of this Moodle. And you are finding, if you observe on this site, here is the assignment which enables teachers to grade and give comments on uploaded files and assignments created on or offline. Similarly, you are also having the chat option. That indicates it allows participants to have a real-time synchronous discussion. Another option is choice. A teacher asks a question and specifies a choice of multiple responses. Similarly, if you move to the database, which enables participants to create, maintain, and search a bank of record entries. Similarly, for the feedback, that for creating and conducting surveys to collect feedback. Forums, that is, it follows participants to have asynchronous discussion, that the students can accordingly interact. Similarly, you have the glossary, you have the lesson, you have the com, you have surveys, you have your wiki, you have your workshops. So this is nothing but these are the different your activities that you can control, and over this documentation, your option, it provides you the entire information about all the activities that you can conduct under Moodle. If you scroll down the documentation our screen, you can also observe on the lower part, it is what is new. Now it means from time to time, different updates are also available. So it could be our anything new that is available, because all the stakeholders, whether it's a teacher or is a student or our admin people or some our mobile related that updates could also be available. So it shows for teachers, for students, for admin, mobile, and also there could be some new feature list that is also available. So that will be available for all the students, all these features. With the entire documentation, you can enjoy and you can have this full information before you start your schedule. So if you just scroll the screen, it will keep you showing for teachers, for admin, for students. This is the information that is available. If you move down, so that is, rather than consulting any printed documentation, you have been provided is a full-fledged online documentation. You can go through and you can accordingly schedule your work using your Moodle. Now let me come back to the other options under MOOC, under this documentation head. In the middle part, we do have manage your site. Here you will find different options. As you see on the screen with a pointer, add users, add courses, change the look and feel, install plugins, because from time to time, to make the learning robust and meaningful, from time to time you will find different updates and different plugins that we need to install onto the software. Apart from this, on the right side, if you look, you do have the Moodle app, and here you find our view app features, first option under this. Similarly, keep up to date with the notifications, create mobile friendly courses, add more app features. So in this way, what you could notice, that under documentation, it provides you the main page that is flooded with several support that any stakeholder, maybe a student, maybe a teacher, maybe the admin people, they could need. Now let me also take you towards the second option, that is downloads. If you click this option, you do find Freedom to Learn screen. Is a Moodle is open source under your GPL license. Under this, it also shows you these are latest release available, and that is your Moodle 3.6.1 plus. Now if you scroll down the screen, have a look at, it shows you four options. If you look, standard Moodle. Now standard Moodle, it could be installed on your own server, but before you install, you must know that what are the prerequisite for the standard Moodle to be installed on your system. It has to have what? A web server with PHP and a database. And you also ought to have what? Your technical expertise for its configuration and setup. Now let's move to second, that is your extend Moodle. If you find, you can browse the extensive Moodle plugins directory for extra activities, blocks, themes, and much more. So it means your Moodle could also be extended, because apart from standard, it could also be made as an enhanced Moodle learning management system. If you move to the next option, which is Moodle Mobile. So with our this Moodle Mobile, we can access learning at a touch of a button even when you are offline with our Moodle mobile app. So it will be available for your Android and iOS. If you move to the rightmost option, that shows Moodle desktop. Here we can have an experience of all the functionalities of the Moodle mobile app on your Windows, Mac, and other Linux based your computer systems. So these are the different four options, and in general, standard Moodle facilitates you with the hands-on exposure. Now, next option is demo. But before we proceed to the demo, I'd also make you aware of these other options on the right side. This is the tracker option. If you click the button, you will find that tracker option gets you the facility to all the stakeholders with our specific dashboard. So what does it do? If you look, it is a system dashboard where it provides the introduction and it welcomes to the Moodle tracker. This is where we record and manage all issues related to Moodle and our related system. If you scroll it down, then you just find that it is having an option to create an account. You can also log in. You can sign up accordingly. So what for it is available? Any kind of issue that you want to submit to Moodle for any kind of resolution. For example, if you come up, because since Moodle is an open source, you think that it has to have some more option. And this option is meant for certain improvement. Or if you come across there is some facility that needs an improvement, or you come across certain bug. So being an open source, our Moodle provides you the flexibility that you can also contribute towards updating and facilitating Moodle learning management system and up-to-date one. So this Moodle tracker, our option, gets you facility to communicate with your Moodle authorities, to the Moodle headquarter, and you can submit in any form you like. I just mentioned that you have a different kind of support through Facebook, through LinkedIn, through your Google, or even with your own, that's your accounts, you can create and you can submit your suggestion, or you can report the bugs.
So we just had a quick tour of the Moodle learning management system, which is an open source. In this module, we have discussed in detail about the background of course management system and learning. We also have deliberated on popular learning and course management systems and tools. Use of a learning management system or course management system by teachers and students. Practical orientation of popular learning and course management system, especially Moodle, that we enjoyed by means of that's your live session. I hope that you would have enjoyed a lot the present module focused on practical use of popular learning and course management system and tools. Thanks a lot, learners, for enjoying this module.